Welcome to this .NET MAUI DataGrid tutorial. In this video, I will demonstrate how to drag and drop columns and rows, track whether the dragged row is dropped in the last position, and customize the appearance of the drag view in the Syncfusion .NET MAUI DataGrid. I open an existing MAUI application. I have already configured the .NET MAUI DataGrid control and bound the orders info to the item's source property. To learn how to add the .NET MAUI DataGrid control to your MAUI application, watch the video linked to the YouTube card above or in the description below. Now, I run the application. You will see the list of order details displayed. To rearrange the columns by dragging them, I set the Allow Drag and Column property to true. Once the application is loaded, you will see that the drag column can be dropped anywhere within the data grid. To customize the behavior of drag and drop, I add the query column dragging event and specify the column dragging method. Next, I will show you how to restrict dragging from a specific column. First, I will navigate to the column dragging method. Within this method, I check if the column being dragged is the first column, and verify that the dragging action has started. If both conditions are met, I cancel the drag to prevent the first column from being moved. Let me run the application to display the changes in behavior. As a result, when I attempt to drag the first column, you will see that it cannot be moved. However, you can drag and drop another column into the first position. Next, I will show you how to freeze columns in a data grid to prevent them from being dragged. To do this, I navigate to the main page XAML and set the number of columns to be frozen in the frozen column count property, ensuring that they remain visible when scrolling horizontally. Let me navigate to the column dragging method and check if the columns being dragged has an index of less than 2 and if the drag operation has just started. If both conditions are met, I cancel the drag operation, preventing these frozen columns from being moved. Once the application is loaded, if I try to move the first two columns, you will see that they are locked in place. Next, I will demonstrate how to control the scrolling behavior when dragging the columns. Before proceeding, I will remove the previous code snippets and simply set the Can Auto Scroll property to false. When I drag a column to the right, you will notice that the data grid remains fixed. To customize the appearance of the indicator in drag view, I move to the main page XAML. Then, define the default style along with the data grid style. To change the color of the drag indicator line, I specify a color in the column dragging indicator line color property. Additionally, I set the color for the text displayed in the drag view and choose a background color to give it a distinctive look while the column is being dragged. Before running the application, I remove the code snippet related to the previous customization. When I drag a column, the drag view and the indicator line are displayed with the customized appearance. Next, I will demonstrate how to drag and drop rows within the data grid. To do this, simply set the Allow Dragging Row property to true. Before running the application, I will comment out the code snippet related to the previous customization. You will see that the dragged row can be dropped anywhere within the data grid. To customize the appearance of the drag view during drag and drop operations, I define a row drag drop template and add a data template. Inside the template, I create a grid with a background color for the drag view. Within the grid, I place a label displaying the text drag view. This label is styled with a text color that ensures clear visibility, and the text is centered both horizontally and vertically. When I start dragging a row, the default drag view is replaced with the custom template. Before proceeding, I remove the code snippet related to the drag view. To customize the drag and drop behavior, I add the query row dragging event and specify the row dragging method. As I have already demonstrated the customization of column drag and drop, I will now focus on the row dragging method and restrict dragging from the first row. When I attempt to drag the first row, you will notice that the drag operation is immediately canceled and the row remains in its original position. Next, I will show you how to display an alert when a row is dropped in the last position of the data grid. First, let me calculate the total height of all the rows in the grid. The function rowColumnIndexToPoint converts the row index to a point on the screen, and the yCoordinate determines the vertical position of the last row. When calculating the total height of all the rows in the grid, be sure to add the height of the last row. Then, check if the dragging action has ended, which confirms that the row has been released after being dragged. During the drag, check the y-coordinate of the mouse, and adjust it by considering half the row height, for better accuracy in determining where the row is dropped. This condition verifies whether the row is dropped below the total height of the grid, and if it is placed in the last position. If both conditions are met, an alert will be displayed, informing that the row has been dropped in the last position. When I drag a row to the last position of the grid, an alert will pop up saying, "The row is dropped at the last position," along with the OK button. Finally, I will customize the appearance of a row when it's being dragged in a data grid. To do this, I navigate to the main page XAML and remove the comment line. Within the data grid style element, I remove the properties related to column drag view style and set the color of the drag indicator line by specifying a color in the row dragging indicator line color property. Next, I will set the color for the text displayed in the drag view, as well as a background color to give it a distinctive look while the row is being dragged. When I drag a row, you will see that the drag view and the indicator line are displayed with a customized appearance. Let me wrap up this video. You have learned how to drag and drop columns and rows, track whether the dragged row was dropped in the last position, and customize the appearance of the drag view in the Syncfusion .NET MAUI DataGrid. If you want to see this example's working code, download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also included a link where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire MAUI controls. If you found this video helpful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.